Hi, in this video, we are starting an introduction to our Rguroo. And the first thing that you need to be able to do with our Rguroo is to import data sets. And if you're working on the first Rguroo workshop for our class, that's one of the first things that it asks you to do. It asks you to upload the serial data set from the Rguroo workbook repository. So a couple things. On the left-hand side of Rguroo, you have your tools. We have data, plots, analytics, probability simulation, and applets. We are importing data, so we're going to click to the left of data. It expands it. Now you can see that I already have the serial data set listed here. However, I'm going to show you how you can find this data set as well. So in order to import a data set, you're going to click on the arrow to the right of data import to drop down a menu. And you're going to click on data set repository. Data set repository. So double click that and a new box will pop up. What you want to make sure is that at the top of this box, it says My Repositories or Public. You want to make sure you choose Public. And then you have two options for finding the repository we're interested in. We are interested in the Wiley Rguroo Workbook Repository. So you can scroll down and find it. You might scroll for a little while. Not too long, though. So let's see. And you'll see it here, Wiley, Rguroo workbook. And you click on it and you will see various data sets that pop up in the bottom window pane. The other way that you can find it instead of scrolling down is you can actually type it in the repository you're interested in, Wiley, Rguroo workbook. And then double click on it that way as well. So either way, you get the same data sets in the repository. And again, that repository is called Wiley Rguroo Workbook. We're interested in the serial data set. So that's the second one in this list. So I click serial and then hit import. It's going to say the following data sets imported successfully. And it labels mine serial parentheses one because I had already had that same data set already. So it's differentiating the two, even though they're the same thing. So I'm going to hit OK. And then I'm going to hit close here because I'm not interested in uploading any more data sets at the moment. So I'm going to hit close. And so if you go over here, you'll see that I have serial listed twice. You should only have it listed once. So I'm going to delete my second one there. You don't need to delete anything. So we all have one data set, and that is serial. So the other thing I'm going to show you is two things. One, how to see the data, and two, how to see a summary of the data. So to see the data, all you have to do, you can do it one of two ways. You can double click and the data set should pop up. So double click the data set, which is serial over here on the left, and then you'll see the data pops up. You can see the serial name, manufacturer, size, shelf, etc. You can scroll down. There's a total of 88 serials. All right. The other way, I'm going to close this out. The other way to do it is to right click on serial and click view. And that will get you to the same place. Now you'll notice a tab has opened up here with the data set. Until you close it, this is going to stay here as long as you are in the current session that you're in. Now, the second thing I told you that I was going to show you how to do is to open just a summary of the data. So we're looking at the raw data from the data set, each individual entry. Now we want to see if we were to summarize the data, what that would look like. So to summarize the data, you highlight or move your cursor over the data set you're interested in this case serial, you right click. And when you right click, this menu pops up and you want to choose data set summary. As soon as you do, you will see that the data summary pops up, and it gives you things like the different variables that are recorded, the number of observations in the data set, the minimum number, things like mean and median that you will learn eventually. But for each of the categories listed, we have, or not categories, the numerical variables listed here. We've got size, price, serving size, calories, etc. If you scroll down, you'll also see a separate table that lists just the categorical variables, so the qualitative variables like serial name and manufacturer, which is the same thing as brand, etc. So there you have it. And if you want to toggle back, now the data set is still open. You don't have to reopen it. If you just arrow over to the tab to the left of the one we just opened, this one has an S on it for, I think, summary. So if we go the one to the left, this shows the data set. So I can go back and forth between the two. And when I'm ready to be finished with one, I can just close it out. Okay, so that's all for this short little video. If you have questions, please, please let me know.